Now we're in a part of Puerto Rico I actually know really well. This is my family hometown of Vega Alta, Puerto Rico. My summer vacations were the best. My sister and I were really sort of left to our own devices. My grandparents worked, and that time that I spent there was really sort of, I think of it as this creative time. It was this sort of summers where I was just left alone with my own imagination.
I used to play in this plaza all the time as a little kid. My grandfather was the general manager of La Cooperativa de Vega Alta. My grandmother owned a travel agency, Viajes Miranda.
And again, as you can hear, siempre hay música en Puerto Rico.
Just living legend, Lucecita Benitez.
What's the importance of this corner?
Papi hizo demasiado de mucho tu abuelo por este pueblo y de alguna manera queremos abrir un espacio para que se recordara la memoria de papi.
Yo me acuerdo cuando retiró de la cooperativa había un festival.
Un festival, era una fiesta.
There's a song in the Heights called Carnaval del Barrio that was based on los carnavales that I would experience here. So talk a little bit about that. Si vienes a Puerto Rico, vienes a Vega Alta, vienes a una fiesta.
El Carnaval de Vega Alta se ha convertido en uno de los carnavales probablemente más importante de Puerto Rico. Es una de las cosas culturales de este pueblo.
What can we expect here in La Placita, if we come visit La Placita de Wisco?
Tenemos mucha cosita típica, lo que nosotros comemos, tú sabes, ahora le llaman chinchorreo, que si la alcapurria, que si el pastelillito, y la pasamos bien.
Es un honor tenerte aquí en La Placita.
Ah, yo estoy feliz porque primero yo no había visto esta placita, no la conocía. Estoy conociéndola hoy y me parece maravilloso. Pero me siento muy feliz y bien orgullosa. Puerto Rico ha dado mucho, mucho talento. Aquí tú levantas una piedra y sale un cantante, salen actores, sale, mira, salió tu hijo, míralo ahí. Aquí el talento es silvestre.
Like it's nothing. Amazing. When did you start playing cuatro?
When I was 4 years old.
4 years old.
Yeah. One of my best experience was when I participated with the symphony orchestra here in Puerto Rico. I was 9 years old.
Wow.
Me as a cuatrista, cuatro player, playing with those masters, I think that experience helped me to expand more my knowledge and focus in that mix of folklore and European music, classical.
I feel like that's been a theme, sort of respect for the culture of Puerto Rico and the generations of tradition, but then also it's 2018 and we continue to evolve and we continue to grow. What's the future of the cuatro?
We are studying there.
You're studying in North Carolina right now, right?
Yeah, School of the Arts, UNCSA. And as me, other cuatrista, studying in other places like Berkeley, we have inside this sentiment to hey, this is the cuatro, Puerto Rican instrument, and we are playing this for you.
Yeah, we'll play a song. My father was the first to leave Puerto Rico for the mainland. He met my mom in New York, and so we grew up in New York, but his brother and sister both stayed on the island. And through my cousins and so many other aunts and uncles I have on the island, I get this glimpse of what life would have been like if we'd stayed, if my father had never
you know, gone to school in New York. It's why I get so happy on Puerto Rican Day Parade Day. This flag that was maybe only hanging up in your window in college is parading down Fifth Avenue and spilling all over New York. It's such a connection for me. It's such a, every time I go, I feel like I'm reconnecting with this thing that's bigger than us, this island we call home.